Welcome back to Only Unconnect, the series, as we go around the tube map visiting stations that just have little ticks, not connected blobs, on the tube map. And you may be surprised, as I was, by the brilliance that is South Harrow. When South Harrow first opened in 1903, it was done so as part of the Metropolitan District Railway, later the District Line, and it wasn't until the early 1930s that it became part of the Piccadilly. The station could have almost been called Roxeth. The nearby National Rail North Holt Park station was called South Harrow and Roxeth when that first opened, and Rayner's Lane Tube Station, one stop up the line, still has his great old tube map showing that there's a Roxbourne as well. Right, now the first thing we must mention is that South Harrow has an old station building. If you walk up the side past the bus station, that's where you get to the original entrance.
Yes, South Harrow does have a station car park. Calm down, car park fans, it's all here. But to walk through this is what takes you to where the original 1903 station building is. And this is it, this is the building here. Now I'm fairly sure that in terms of like disused stations, ghost stations, this counts because this is the original, now therefore abandoned and disused South Harrow station, opened in 1903 by the District Railway. Sadly, there's signs of it saying, you know, it's in a little bit of disrepair, so be careful. There's like a missing circular plaque. It looks as if at one stage there might have been one of those blue plaques on there with some historical references, but now I'm fairly sure it is in use, but mainly just as a PNR. Point a personal need relief for the drivers, because I'm fairly sure that sometimes I see the drivers on the southbound stop here nip in, use the loo, and then get the train back out again. You can see it from outside on the street, and also if you go to the southern end from the platform, and also if I go up here, there's a really good view from a footbridge as well.
So from the footbridge that's just to the south of the station, you get a view of the carriage sidings that are just here, and I want to say you get a good view of that and a good view of the station, but they've got a protective grille up covering all the sides and the roof, so for a shot of the station I have to do the thing with the camera lens where I sort of blur out the actual metal grille part and zoom in to get an excellent view of South Harrow station.
The other brilliant thing which you need to know is at South Harrow station is that just to the north is an old spur of disused track, now heavily truncated, which ran to the Harrow and Stanmore Gas Company. Let's go and find it.
I mean, I have been here before, it's not my first time here, but it just seems to be one of those tube oddities, bit of history that's often overlooked, not often talked about, so it's splendid just to come and visit again the spur off the Piccadilly and this remnant that's still here today.
If you want more details, the London Underground Railway Society has an incredibly in-depth article about it. Link in the description. Back at the station, and the Charles Holden design building is an absolute classic which you can't but not just love. This clock is great. There's an old destination light box which sadly no longer works. And then, by this assistance booth, look up and make sure you notice the fake owl that's here, hopefully keeping the pigeons at bay. Right then, onto the steps, where there's another oddity which I always love.
South Harrow also has benches halfway down the stairs. You get stairs down, flat bit, stairs down. Where the flat bit is, there's benches. I can't think of any other tube station where there's benches halfway down the stairs.
And is it me, or does South Harrow have one of the widest staircases of any station? Using the measure app on my phone, I made it 4.4 metres wide here, and I'm trying to think of any tube station which might have a wider staircase. Back on the platforms, the station waiting rooms have got these gorgeous Charles Holden curved designs too. It's just a shame you can't go in them anymore, as a simple sign on the door with a sad tale explains why.
See it, safe, sorted.
Now I've no idea why the tiles on the pillars are this colour of gold and yellow, but I did spot that the platforms used to be longer at the northern end of the station. These sections though are now definitely out of use, but it's a good place to stand to spot the trains coming over the sort of viaduct over Roxeth Marshes. And then just time for a quick bit of shopping.
By the way, just away from the station, but opposite the station, is this South Harrow Market. It's an indoor market. When I think of indoor markets, I think of Brixton and Camden. I had no idea that South Harrow had one, and it's marvellous.
And not forgetting the obligatory bin bag in the breeze shot, whilst I contemplate the meaning of life and why on earth, TFL, is the spacing between the letters on the sign out front not consistent? That's the sort of thing that keeps me awake at night.
And that is Unconnected, only South Harrow. Here comes my train. Gonna do one for every line, so this was the Piccadilly. I might do like the DLR and the Overground and the trams as well. I've no idea which stations on those lines are unconnected. I guess we'll find out. Thanks for watching. Press subscribe. See you soon.